So let's take some examples based on the optimization problems that we have introduced before, so like the knapsack problem. What would be an example of a neighborhood for the knapsack problem? The current solution is a vector of binary variables. So for each I, for each item I, the value is 0 if the I is currently not in the sack, and 1 if I is currently considered to be in the sack. Well, what would be a simple neighbor solution would be to select an item j and change the decision about it to replace xj by 1 minus xj. So if xj was 0, it becomes 1, and if it was 1, it becomes 0. Of course, like we did in the previous example, we always need to check feasibility, so if the total weight is not exceeded. And we can also generalize this idea. So another possibility of a neighborhood would say, instead of changing one item, let's change two items. So we select two items and we change the decision for these two items. And then we can generalize for k items. So a neighborhood of size k is a neighborhood that selects k items and change the decision for all of them. And of course, we need to check feasibility. And actually, this is interesting because this is how we should look at the complexity of the neighborhood, because we said we want the neighborhood to be not too small and not too large. Actually, a neighborhood of size k modifies k variables. So how many neighbors are generated? Well, the number of neighbors is n factorial divided by k factorial times n minus k factorial. So if you take k equals 1, which is the first neighborhood that I suggested, you will have n neighbors. And if you take k equals n, basically you change the decision for all items, you have only one neighbor. So this is definitely too small. Let's now consider the traveling salesman problem and give an example of a neighborhood. Well, one very popular neighborhood structure that is used for this problem is called two-opt. So we have a tour, which is a current order of the cities to be visited. And then we select two cities among them. And then what we do is that we swap the position in the tour, and then all the intermediate cities will be visited in the reverse order. So let's take an example. So here we have an example where the current tour is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, back to A. Okay. And then we select two cities. We will take C and G. And then we swap them. So we will have G here and C here. And everything else will be in the reverse order. So we go A, B, G, and then F, E, and D. So we obtain the new tour, which is A, B, G, F, E, D, C, H, A. So let's take the solution that we have obtained previously using the greedy heuristic, if you remember. The length of this tour is 165.6. So this is the tour which is actually reported here. And what we will do is to try to improve it by using the two-opt neighborhood structure to generate one neighbor. And here we will be swapping node 1 and node 9. Okay, so this is what we have done here, node 1, node 9. So everything else is the same. We have swapped 9 and 1, and all the other nodes are followed in the reverse order. So we have 9, 10, 4, 3, 2, 1. And in this case, the tour that we obtain is 173.3, so there is no improvement. So this is the original solution. So I have node 9 here and node 1 here. If you follow the tour from H, so you had H, 8, 7, 11, 6, 5, and then the idea was to go to 1. But now in the new tour, we'll go to 9 instead. Okay, we go to 9 here. And then what we do is that we follow the nodes in the reverse order. So we go 10, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then we go to H. Well, unfortunately, in this case, the neighbor that you have generated is not better than the previous one. But we can use a local search. So what we will do is that we will consider each pair of nodes and apply two-opt. So this is a neighborhood structure. and we will apply our idea is that we will enumerate these neighbors and select the one which is the best. So this is the current tour. And now we have applied the two-opt neighborhood structure by swapping node 8 and node 4. And we have obtained a better tour. So the previous one, 165.6, this one, and now the new tour, after applying the two-opt neighborhood structure, has a length of 155.8. So let's continue. We have here a new tour which is obtained by swapping 8 and 9 to obtain a length of 143. Then we swap 11 and 7 to obtain a length of 139.5. We swap 7 and 10 to get a length of 137.5. 10 and 9 to get a length of 130.7. And now, if we start from this solution, all the possibilities to make a two-opt transformation, they will all produce a longer tour. Therefore, this is a local optimum for this neighborhood structure. So we have improved a lot the original solution produced by the greedy heuristic. And now we have a tour which has a length which is low. We have no clue if it is the optimal solution. We will never know, except if we solve it using an exact method. But from all practical purposes, it's certainly better to use this tour than the one that was generated by the greedy heuristic. So if we want to generate another solution that hopefully can be better than this one, what we could do is to change the starting point and apply the same technique again. So it may land on the same local optimum, but as we have seen before, it may also land on a different local optimum. And then we can decide which one of the two is the best and do it again and again. So this is called diversification. But we have seen as well that changing the neighborhood structure will also change the, or may potentially change the local optimum that we reach, which is another way to diversify the algorithm. And actually, this technique is called the variable neighborhood search. So it's a method of diversification that basically considers several neighborhood structures. Then we apply a local search for a given neighborhood structure, and then we change the structure. So we continue from the point that we have obtained using another neighborhood structure. So this is the method. So we define first k neighborhood structures instead of one, as we have seen for the local search. And we start from an initial solution x0. For the initialization, we define the current iterate as x0. And we initialize the counter of neighborhoods to k equals 1. So we will start with the first neighborhood. Then at each iteration, we apply the local search, starting from xi, the current iterate, and using vk as a neighborhood structure. The solution that we obtain is x plus, so this is the solution of the local search. And now we have to decide. So if x plus happens to be better than the current iterate, then x plus becomes the current iterate, and we reinitialize the counter of neighborhood. So we will start again from neighborhood number one. If not, if the solution provided by this neighborhood is not good, so is not better than the current iterate, we consider the next neighborhood. So we increase k by 1. And we do this until k reaches capital K. So it means that we have investigated all possible neighborhoods without being able to improve the solution, the current solution. Let's take an example. We will consider here the knapsack problem. And as we have seen, we can define a neighborhood of size k by modifying k variable. So we consider k items and we change the decisions made for these k items. So here we modify a little bit the local search because, as we have seen, the number of neighbors can be quite high. So we start from the current iterate and we randomly select a neighbor. So basically, instead of enumerating all neighbors, I mean, because depending on the value of k, the number of neighbors can be quite high, we just pick one randomly. We call it x plus. And if x plus happens to be better than xc, it becomes the new candidate. Not that being better here means two things. First, it must be feasible, and the utility associated with x plus must be strictly larger than the utility associated with the current candidate. And then we repeat it 1,000 times for any k. So the advantage of this technique is that the complexity of this method is independent of the value of k. So this chart illustrates how this algorithm, the variable neighborhood search algorithm, can be applied on a knapsack problem. On the x-axis, you have the iteration. So we have performed 20 iterations. And then on the left y-axis, you have the value of the utility function. This is represented by the curve in green. And then we have also plotted on this chart, and which is represented on the right y-axis, the size of the neighborhood. So this is a knapsack problem with 12 items. So we have tried all neighborhood structures with k equals 1 until k equals 12. So this is iteration 1. We are using a neighborhood of size 1. At iteration 2, we find a better solution. So the value of the utility has increased a lot. Okay. We reset the counter for the neighborhood structures. So we start again with value k equals 1, and then it fails. It does not find a better neighbor. So we do it now with a neighborhood of size 2, and it succeeded in finding a better solution here. Great, so we found a better candidate. So we reset now the value of the neighborhood counter. So we start again with k equals 1, okay? Then k equals 2, k equals 3, no improvement, k equals 4, no improvement. And here, with a neighborhood of size 5, we are able to improve the solution. Okay, so we've reached this value of the utility function. And then we reset the size of the neighborhood. So we start again with a neighborhood of size 1. And now if you look at this line here, so we are trying all the possible neighborhood structure, and none of them is able to improve the value of the solution. And therefore, once we have reached 12, so the maximum size of the neighborhood, we stop and we provide the current candidate as the solution of the algorithm.